In this video lecture, we're going to take a quick look at the endless loop problem with while looping and how to avoid it in the first place. Okay, let's get started. So we've already seen that a while loop usually requires three things to be well behaved: a priming read to get the loop started, a properly formed loop continuation condition to check whether or not to continue looping, and an update read to give the continuation condition a chance to become false and thereby terminate execution. Having these three things in place will give us a nice properly controlled while loop. By contrast, an endless loop or an infinite loop happens when the body of a while loop executes continuously without ending. By the way, just as an interesting aside, Apple Computer's headquarters is located at One Infinite Loop in Cupertino, California. I say for now because I understand Apple is planning a new corporate campus nearby, but I digress. There are two primary symptoms of an infinite loop. If there's no output being displayed to the screen, your program may appear as if it's hung and not doing anything or responding. If there is output being displayed, often it's being spewed endlessly. In either case, it's game over, and you, the user, have to terminate program execution somehow. There are two common causes or gotchas which can lead to such infinite loops. One cause is inadvertently putting a semicolon after the while condition instead of the typical opening curly brace. What this does is it creates an empty loop body in between the condition and that semicolon, which is executed endlessly, but the following code block within curly braces that we wanted to have executed never gets its chance. The other common cause, and this might be more typical, is forgetting to add some update read near the end of our while block of statements. If we forget this, we never give our loop continuation condition a chance to eventually become false, and we have an infinite loop on our hands. Let's take a look at examples of both these causes. In this first example on the left, the gotcha is that we have this semicolon, shown in red, directly following the loop continuation condition. What happens is that your program will never get past this while condition because this imaginary empty block of statements between this closing parenthesis and this semicolon is cycled through infinitely. Nothing ever takes place to update this tempf variable, so this loop just spins endlessly and makes your program appear to be hung. In the second example, we do have a statement block bounded by this curly brace pair, but now the gotcha is that we have forgotten one thing, an update read. We never give this item cost variable a chance to change its value from whatever it started the loop with, so this too becomes an endless loop and makes your program appear to be hung. Now in this case, there is the possibility that this total variable will eventually overflow and crash the program, but depending upon its data type, that could be a really long time, and the program would still appear to be hung until then. In either case, to remedy either of these infinite loops and terminate program execution, you'd need to click the End button in JGrasp's command window. That's really the only way out of this. Having said all this, there actually is a specific situation where you would want an infinite loop. In embedded systems programming in C or C++, a code structure such as this on the right might represent one specific task in an embedded systems application. There is literally such a while true nature to specific tasks, which execute endlessly until directed otherwise. Now, in this kind of situation, these tasks are themselves under the control of some larger embedded real-time operating system, or RTOS, so it's not really a runaway kind of situation, but it is a notable exception to what we've just discussed. So don't let it freak you out if you encounter this in embedded systems programming someday. To wrap things up and see some examples of infinite loops, please view the short code walkthrough video for loopingwhileendless.java, which you'll find in the usual place. Open up this file in JGrasp so you can follow along. And that will conclude this short overview of endless while looping.